look at what's going on in the big picture. We're going to see rain Thursday night and especially during the early part of the day coming up on Friday. It really could be quite heavy. What we've got is a developing storm system that's going to be very large in its breadth and width. It's really going to take over much of the eastern half of the United States, already producing some flooding rains from Missouri on to Arkansas and on down toward Louisiana. But this thing will take shape and it will indeed affect our weather again Thursday night, but especially Friday. Today, very, very quiet throughout the area. It's going to be quiet tomorrow, too. Thursday looks great, but then we get into Thursday evening. We're going to go from Thursday evening at 7 into Friday evening at 7. Show you what's going on in terms of rainfall moving in. Anything we're moving in overnight? Take it to Friday morning. No, not that much. 7 o'clock in the morning, a zero or a hundredth of an inch. A few scattered showers, that's about it. But obviously, something's moving on in. And we can see some showers and some thunderstorms into the area. You'll note two and a third inches of rainfall, not quite as much a little bit farther east, but we add some more to that coming up by the end of the day. And if the forecast model is off just by, let's say, 20 miles, well, it could be right through the heart of the Hampton Roads cities with some of this 2 1/3, 3 inches of rainfall. So we'll want to watch it carefully. 3 inches of rainfall, we normally get a little over 4 inches of rain per month. So to get 3 inches of rain in under 12 hours, that's a lot. Here's what's going on. 7 o'clock this evening, all is very quiet. Winds become more northeasterly overnight. We'll drop into the low 50s inland, upper 50s near the coastline. Here's where tomorrow afternoon at 3, 72, a couple of degrees cooler for the day coming up for tomorrow. Cloudiness is moving in. Rain with that, well, it's going to take a while for it to get here. We can see stray showers overnight, but the bigger rain starts lining up to our west coming up by Friday morning at 7. And we're talking thunderstorms out of these with some heavy rainfall into the region Friday morning. There's our Friday morning at 10. Still some pockets of heavy rainfall into the region. And between 10 and 1, it slides on through the south side and over the eastern shore as well, and then moves on out to sea. Not entirely. We'll still see a stray shower, too, for the rest of the day coming up into Friday. But again, it looks like the big stuff between around 7 o'clock and around 1 o'clock in the afternoon coming up on Friday. By Friday evening, again, it's all gone, moving out to sea for the most part. This is the long-range version of Future Track. And again, it's a little bit blockier resolution, but showing you what's going on. By Saturday morning, cool. Saturday during the day into the 60s, a stray shower is indeed possible. There are the overnight hours, a stray shower, too. There's Sunday morning, and then Sunday during the day, it stays on the cool side throughout the area. So again, 72, couple of degrees cooler. Cloud cover starts moving in during the afternoon hours. Stray shower overnight, but our best chance of rain comes early in the day on Friday, where we can see 2 inches of rainfall into the area during the day. We'll watch that real, real carefully. Stray shower or two on Saturday, and definitely cooler for Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday.